Hello friends, schoolsteps.in welcomes you again. In the last tutorial we worked on mobile module and in this tutorial we'll work on the wearable module. Let's continue. In the last tutorial we worked on the mobile module and we worked on the code to send the message. In this tutorial we'll work on the wear module and we need to find a way to monitor the data layer for the new messages. This is possible in two ways. One is to use a listener service and the other one is to use the listener activity. I repeat, the first way is to use the listener service and the second way is to use the listener activity. In this tutorial, we will use the first way, that is listener service. Let's do it. Under the Wear module, expand Java, right click on the package and create a new Java class. Let's give the name as My Listener Service. Now we need to extend this class to the Wearable Listener Service. So we need to say extends Wearable Listener Service. The next thing which we need to do is to declare two variables. These variables are exactly the same as we declared in the mobile module. Next we need to override the method onMessageReceived. Let's do it. Select and click OK. Inside this method, the first thing that we need to do is to put one if else condition. So we need to say if message event, which we are getting from here as a parameter, dot get path dot equals wearable data path, then do something else, execute the super dot on message received. Now if you see the if condition, we are comparing the path with the wearable data path and the value is exactly the same as we put in the mobile module. So that way we are confirming if the message is coming from the same path from where we sent it. Now inside the if condition, the first thing that we need to do is to receive our message. So we need to say final string message is equal to new string. And inside the parameter, we need to say message event dot get data. So this will return us the message that we passed through the mobile module. Now we need to pass this message to the main activity. And for that purpose, we need to use the intent. So we need to say intent start intent is equal to new intent. And here we need to pass this comma main activity dot class. Next, we need to say start intent dot put extra and we need to pass our message right here. Next we need to add two flags. The first flag is intent dot flag activity clear task and the second flag is flag activity new task. We are using this flag because we are trying to start the main activity out of the activity context and we are using this flag to clear the history. Now next thing which we need to do is to start the activity and let's place one log statement right here. Before we proceed further, I need to explain you one important concept regarding the wearable listener service. This service runs in the background and is available to you whenever a desired event occurs. For example, on receiving a message or on data change. We'll talk about the data change in our next tutorial. Now when we say this service runs in the background, that further means that your wearable application doesn't need to be in the forefront as this service is a part of your wearable application. The next thing that we need to do is to register our service class. Go to the project, expand wearable, go to source and look for android manifest.xml of wear module. And right here after the activity, we need to register our service. So we have defined a tag with the name service and inside the name, we have defined my listener service, which is the name of our class. Make sure to place a dot before that. Further, we have defined the intent filter and inside the intent filter, we have defined a tag with the name action. And here the name which we have defined is com. Dot Google dot Android dot GMS dot wearable dot bind underscore listener. So this will register our service. Now let's go back to our service class again. So right here inside the service class, we are opening the main activity and we are passing a message to main activity dot class. Now we need a way to read this particular message inside the main activity. So let's open the main activity of wear module. So right here inside the onCreate method, where we are getting the object of text view, just after that we need to say getIntent dot get string extra. We need to pass message here. This is the key which we defined while sending our message, and this will return us a string value. Next, we need to check the string value for null or blank value. If this is the case, let's set the default value. Now, last but not the least, we need to set the value to mTextView. So we need to say mTextView.setText and we need to pass our message right here. Now, next thing that we need to do is to make a small change in the mobile module. So go to project, expand mobile module, expand source, expand main, expand res, and under the res folder look for the layout folder and open activity underscore main.xml. Open it, go to the design view, and right here we need to delete this hello world, and we need to place one editable text right here. Further, we need to place a button below this editable text box. Now let's go to the source and let's make some changes right here. Let's change the ID of edit text to text. Let's change this text to send message. We have to change this ID to text as well, as we have defined text here. And last but not the least, let's define one onClick property. And let's call a method with the name send message onClick on the click event of button. Now we need to implement this method in the main activity of mobile module. Let's do it. So this is the main activity of mobile module, and right after the send message method, we need to implement our method. So we need to say public void send message on click, and we need to pass view as a parameter. And inside this method, we need to call send message. So what exactly will happen when the first time we open our application and the connection will be created? It will call the onConnected method, which will further call sendMessage method. Now this will happen only once. Further, if you want to call sendMessage method again on the click event of the button, then we need to implement it like this. We are done with our program. Let's run it and let's see the output. On the screen, you can see my device, and in the background, emulator is running. Wear module is running on the emulator. I have installed the mobile module on the cell phone, though I still need to run it. On the emulator, you can see the default value, that is hello world. Now I will close the application on the Wear module. This is to make sure that service is running in the background on the Wear module. And once we run the program on the cell phone device, this service will be invoked. Let's do it. The moment I open the program on the cell phone device, the Wear service is invoked. Now let's quickly change the value on the cell phone device. I have changed the value on the cell phone to my first message. Let's click on the send message button. The moment I click on the button, it will change the value on the Wear emulator. Now let's quickly discuss some points which we talked about in the previous tutorial. So messages are one-way request, we are clear on this. If the handheld and the wearable are connected, the system queues the message for delivery and returns a successful result code. We have done it. If the devices are not connected, an error is returned. A successful result code doesn't indicate that message was delivered successfully. We have already talked about it. The next point is that message API can send messages. We have already seen that. We have sent message to the wearable device and we started the activity over there. Extending to the wearable service lets you listen to the important data layer events in a service. We know that it runs in the background. And last but not the least, the data listener. If you remember, we talked about the activity listener. So if we use this, we need to make sure that our activity is running in the foreground. So this is the alternate to wearable listener service. Friends, with this, I take your leave. Thank you so much. Please like our page on facebook.com/letsandroid. If you have any query, do write us at info@schoolsteps.in or schoolstepsin@gmail.com. Thank you.